Prior to the launch of Operation Shujaa, President Felix Tshisekedi of the Democratic Republic of Congo and President Yoweri Kaguta Museveni signed an agreement on how the operation would be executed. On 30th of November, the UPDF Air Force launched airstrikes against Allied Democratic Forces rebels, targeting four of their major camps, including Kambia Jua, Tondoli, Beli 1, and Beli 2. According to the operation's spokesperson, Major Peter Mugisa, this was intended to dislodge the ADF from Virunga and Ituri forests, which were previously referred to as the Triangle of Death.
Have dislodged the ADF in their decade-long stay in those camps, more especially in the Virunga forest and the Ituri forest, what is commonly known by Congolese as the Triangle of Death. The Triangle of Death has been used by ADF to kill and maim, steal people's properties for a very long time.
Currently, Operation Shujaa is under Phase 2 after successfully completing Phase 1, as Major Mugisa explains.
One involved the use of long-range artillery and also Air Force, where it was aimed at dislodging or disrupting ADF in their formerly known camps. And it also led to the ground forces to go and sweep through those camps and either kill or dislodge them completely from those camps.
According to Major Mugisa, the Operation Shujaa has, among other achievements, managed to break the command structure of the ADF, recovered military hardware from the military outfit, as well as rescued some abductees. The Operation Shujaa has also opened up and secured access routes between Uganda and Congo, which has boosted trade between the two countries.
Now a reduction in the killings of civilians in Eastern Democratic Republic of Congo, just because of the combined forces of FRDC and UPDF. Other achievements are some and many of the guns of assorted guns of different calibers have been recovered.
But despite the ongoing military operation, Uganda continues to receive more asylum seekers fleeing conflict in Congo, which Major Mugisa attributes to rebel activity after the ADF were dislodged from their camps.
These are running away from their homes, coming towards the Ugandan side, especially on the Nobilo Kamango approach. That is that's the first road. You can remember that in February, the ADF that was dislodged from their camps, especially Kambia Yua, they ran towards the south, hence coming towards the Nobir border.
Operation Shujaa has also suffered setbacks ranging from the difficult terrain as well as thick vegetation that is very difficult to maneuver through.
But the terrain, the difficult terrain. You see, Virunga forest, Ituri forest, as you hear them, they are not forests per se, but the terrain is really very, 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 very difficult. Where there are gorges, there are valleys, steep hills, thick vegetation.
Despite the setbacks, Major Mugisa says that the UPDF, together with the Congolese forces, are determined to totally eliminate the ADF.
We want to ensure that we terrorize these terrorists so that we live in a peaceful way.
ADF is one of the several rebel outfits seeking control of natural resources in eastern Congo. The group was formed in 1995 in Uganda, but later moved into the Democratic Republic of Congo. This report was compiled by Rogers Sunday for the news.